Curtis King.
Yeah, why you singing at me?
Got a question, man. How do I make more effective Facebook ads and Twitter ads? Well, I'm glad you asked. I had somebody pose a question last week within my comments, and they asked me, they said, I sure did. Anyways, they asked me, because I can't pronounce ask. They asked me, they said, Curtis, how do I make more effective ads within my Facebook campaign, within my Twitter campaign? What do I need to do? And they say this as if I did not make a whole series about driving traffic to your website. It's fine. I'll go over this portion again. But what I'm going to go over is native content. It comes back to native content. What makes your ads and what makes your Facebook ads and your Twitter ads more effective? It's literally posting as if you are a citizen of that particular network. It's not by posing as if you're an alien of that network. Now, that's what most rappers and brands and even a lot of corporations do. They go posting crazy, and their posts are, they stand out so much because they're so heavily I don't even know what the word is. It's just too much damn text on the damn ads. And it's like an eyesore to the point where when you're on your phone and you're scrolling down, you automatically know the stuff to skip over without even reading two letters because you're like, oh God, it's an ad. Oh my God, it's a flyer. That's why when you get on Instagram, the least amount of the pictures that get the least amount of likes are flyers and things with text on them. So to make more effective ads, you got to think about the things that are being posted even within your particular fan base or your particular friend timeline. Just go look. Is it pictures? I'm guaranteeing you it's a lot of pictures that are posting up. Is it video? I'm guaranteeing you it's video. Well, what kind of pictures and what kind of videos? I'm guaranteeing you it's pictures without any kind of text on them and this stuff that's really appeasing to the eye. So if you're trying to promote your music video, for instance, maybe find a scene, or even when you're shooting a video, have your videographer taking screenshots. He can't take screenshots with a camera, but basically have him take photos during the shoots. You have high res photos that people will be like, that's an interesting photo, I wonder what that's from. So say for instance you got a video where you and your dog are jumping off of the roof and somebody snaps a picture of that. You don't think somebody will be like, yo, what the heck is this? And especially if you leave a caption that says, see why me and my dog jumped off the roof. And then you have this link that leads to your music video. So as you're doing boosted ads and you're doing boosted ads, and you're doing your regular advertisement, you're going to see that it gets a better reaction. Why? Because it's more general and it's more natural. It's just native to the actual website that you're using. One thing about Facebook, people don't like to leave Facebook. Don't make them leave Facebook. So if you're going to post a video, put the video within Facebook. Facebook will actually help you out on the algorithm, which is a whole nother thing. I got a video about that. But Facebook will actually help boost you up higher in the timeline on the newsfeed if you are using their particular tools to promote your content. That is one. Now, when it comes to videos, if you go to my Curtis King Beats Facebook page, you're gonna see videos that have popped up where I made a video, made the meme video where I put the text and it's easy to read. You know exactly within 5 seconds what it is. That's something else too, knowing it within 5 seconds what the hell you're looking at. I put the video up and then I have the meme, and it basically said, Curtis, it says, producer tags are out of control. And then in the actual video, you're starting to look at it, and then the actual caption that I say, I don't say, watch my video. I don't say, this video is crazy. I don't say, Curtis King does a crazy funny video. No, because it's going to be sponsored in front of people who don't know who the hell I am. So if that's the case, how do I get a complete stranger to want to care about my content? Well, I make it, first of all, niche down. I make it very detailed to who I'm talking to. I said something like, hip-hop producer tags are out of control. And then I think I might have put like a few emoji faces, because emoji faces get more attention. It's just basically getting creative. When you look at the game and not look at it like, I got to do my marketing and my advertising, when you stop looking at it from such technical terms, it actually becomes fun. All these rules that I'm talking about on Facebook, they apply to Twitter. Use the native content, use the tools that they give you on Twitter, because they want to keep people that are on Twitter on Twitter. And if your content starts to get a lot of traffic and a lot of traction, they'll keep pushing it up to the top of the timeline. So if you really want to learn how to make effective ads, you just have to ask yourself, what are the things that get your attention? Once again, it's another Curspiration. Look, subscribe to the channel if you need some more of this juice. Notification, gang, gang, gang. And also, that wasn't awkward at all. And also, look, man, if you want to make effective ads, just think of the things. I'm slapping my hands like a ratchet right now. If you want to find the things that are effective for the general population, ask what's effective for you. And if you looked at that flyer, you looked at that picture with the bad font, would it give you a good feeling? Then it's probably not doing that for everybody else. In this life, you will not be full of life until you decide to live life to the fullest. Curtis King of CurtisKingBeast.com. How? When I listen to you, it's a liability. Cause you be mentally killing my inner energy. So I'm concealing my feelings before you injure me.